Let's see what it takes to create our very first directive. So we're going to create in our main.js an app called, we'll just call it superhero, and no dependencies. And then we'll just say app directive, and this is one of those syntaxes you just need to memorize. And we'll create a Superman directive. And from this callback, we'll return an object with a property called restrict. We'll restrict it to capital E, which is element. And we'll say this is a template of, let's inject HTML so I can use Zen coding or Emmet. Div, and we'll say here I am to save the day. Now that we have a superhero module with a Superman directive, which is restricted to E, we can jump into our index, create our app, which is superhero, and create our element here, which is using our directive called Superman. So then once we refresh this and check out over here, you can see it says, here I am to save the day. So that's really all there is to writing your very first directive. We'll get into the details of what's going on here in the next future videos, but basically as soon as you have an app, you can attach directives to that app or that module. And in your HTML, you basically make sure you define your elements inside of your app. It's not going to work if you put this outside of that, because it's only going to work in the scope that app will allow.